All right, Vermont Dave, this video's for you. Check it out. So, I'm anchored up at Vaca Cut, right? And huge mullet, probably about that big, live mullet, caught last night in the cast net that I found, believe it or not, found a 12-foot cast net out in front of my canal, just sitting, floating. Well, sink. The line was floating, but the net was, you know what I mean. Found a brand new cast net. Caught some live bait last night, some mullet, and put them in the bait hotel and hooked it up. Landed a huge fish. Yes, landed it. Leader touch. That is landing a fish in your book. I got some video and some pictures. You weren't here to help me out, so the video is not so good, and I couldn't land the boat in the fish in the boat, but. Anyway, watch the video and tell me what you think.
All right, I don't know if you can see this, but I just landed a fucking huge tarpon all by myself. Well, almost landed. Let me get him a little closer. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, it's a brute. Can you see him? I can't see him.
So this is like 20 minutes in. I finally got a chance to grab the camera. Believe it or not, I'm driving the boat. The current's ripping in. It's coming. It's ripping in from the ocean. I'm driving the boat, trying to keep the boat straight, fighting the fish. And then I finally grabbed the camera, I'm zipping it with my teeth, and I'm taking this, and it was dark, all I had was my headlight. I got the camera in my teeth. So he already made his few runs. First he ran me bayside, and then he ran me under the bridge. I'm trying to fight the fish drive, it was crazy. I got another video, check this one out. I mean, I was just snapping him, I was just keep hitting the button, hopefully to get a good shot, but... But anyway, watch this.
All right, I just caught a big tarpon. There's a shark on him. I don't know if it's a hammerhead or a bull, but the fish was almost in the boat, and then he just took off. Hang tight. There's a big shark on this fish. This fish was almost ready to be landed, and then he just took off a nice, good 50-yard run again. I'd like to say there's a big shark on this fish. Oh yeah, there's a shark on him. He's going again. I'm gonna have to turn the boat around and get back on him. Oh shit, he's going back towards the bridge.
Joker was screaming. You hear that drag? Freaking Spiros 8000 was freaking on fire. I don't know how. This thing is cranked down all the way. It will not turn anymore. Look at this. Let me wrap my hand around here. That will barely. I can barely pull that drag. It is wrapped down all the way. And that fish was just. Wah! Freaking hammered down. Oh, goodness. Anyway, so I didn't see the shark, but I would like to assume that fish was by the boat, sideways. I was going to freaking lip him and at least pull him up a little, and then all of a sudden he took off. I would like to say there was a shark definitely on that fish. I'm in Vaca Cut. It's at least, you know, 30, 40 feet there. There's some big bulls, hammerheads, they say, hang out there. So anyway, yeah, that thing was screaming. Did you hear that? Let's see what else we got here. Hold on a second. Alright, so here's a picture of the fish. All blurry. There's a nice shot right there. See the girth of that fish. Water was pretty clear, but it was dark. So there's another one with him kind of rolling right there. Another nice shot. pictures don't do justice, but this was a really big fish. That's a pretty decent one right there. I'm horsing them up, trying to get them up high. There's me, pictures, fishing, everything at once right there, him in the background. There's a nice photo right there. Very big fish. There's another one with the red eyes shining. I had him close to the boat. I had him like that a few times, and that's the aftermath right there. Busted the rod three places. Right there, three places, busted the rod. Oh. So that's it. That's my tarpon. I'll show you what happened here. Broke this rod. The rod did good. The rod was good for the fight. I knew I wasn't going to be able to land the fish, so I was hopefully just get it close to the boat. And I just, he was pulling me towards the bridge. So the current was moving pretty fast, so I just yanked up on the rod, hopefully to pop it, and the line didn't pop. I was using this 80-pound mono, which some of the other captains in the area, they said that's light. They usually use 100 or 120, 150 even. I was using 80, and I tried to pop it out of them, and it didn't work. I had a big old, I believe it's a 6 or an 8 circle hook, right through the nose of the mullet, and it didn't break. So I'm horsing them up trying to pop it before the boat slammed into to the bridge, and the rod broke. So I grabbed a towel, wrapped it around my hand, and everything I could, I pulled up and finally popped the line. There's no fray at all in the line, maybe a little bit right here, but fish is just incredible fish. So get on back here and catch one, man. There's plenty of them. See you later, man.